Now, some of you may not know that tithe, back in the Old Testament time, went from the large number down to the small number. The time we're going to read about in Luke is around 3 B.C. God had a plan, and His plan is perfect. No matter what we think about it, His plan is perfect.
Yes, sir.
So before we read, I want to give you some history. Nebuchadnezzar sent his army down to Judea to capture it around 587 B.C. Took all the children of Israel into bondage, and they stayed there for many years. Finally, the children of Israel began to come back into the Holy Land of God. When they begin to come back, they needed a place to worship. But what happened was the Roman Empire came in and took possession of the land of Israel at that time. So to keep from causing a ruckus, we might say, the Roman, by the name of Herod, decided that he would build back the temple of God so the people of God could have a place to worship, and that would keep down trouble and aggravation. Mm-hmm. So he built it the best he could, but the problem is, when Nebuchadnezzar came in and destroyed Jerusalem and tore it down and burned it to the ground, he also, the Ark of the Covenant of God disappeared. It was gone. It's still gone. Mm-hmm. Now, they rebuilt the temple, Herod did, so the people would stop being so rough and aggravating and would obey what he said. So the time has changed now, where there's a forerunner coming that's going to make a big difference in the way we worship God and the salvation of God. So let us read now in Luke chapter 1, starting at verse 5. The temple's rebuilt, keep that in mind. It's not complete without the Ark of the Covenant of God, but the temple's there.
Yes, sir.
There was in the days of Herod the king of Judah a certain priest named Zacharias of the course of Abba, and his wife was the daughter of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blameless, and they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren. And they both were now well stricken in years. And it came to pass that while he executed the priest office before God in the order of his course, according to the custom of the priest office, his lot was to burn incense when he went into the temple of the Lord. And the whole multitude of the people were praying without at the time of incense. I want to go back to Isaiah chapter 40 for just a minute and read you something. It says, comfort ye my people, saith God. Speak ye comfortable to Jerusalem and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquities be pardoned, for she has received of the Lord hand double for all her sins. Now watch this. The voice of him that cried in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough places smooth. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed.
Yes.
And all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. Heavenly Father, thank you, dear God. I'm going to open your word, Master, and do the very best I can for your glory. because I want people to see that there is a way.
Yes.
And Jesus is going to make that way, that we can be set completely free of all our sins if we confess our sins and give them to Him. We praise this day, dear God, and glorify Your name. Have Your way in our life, dear Father, for we ask it in Jesus' name, and amen, and amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. I want to go through these scriptures because we read them, and we zip through them, and nobody knows what we read. Amen?
Yeah.
In verse 5 of St. Luke, chapter 1, it says, there was in the days of Herod, the king of Judah, a certain priest named Zechariah of the course of Abba. When you go back to look in Chronicles, the 24th chapter, there is an order that all the priests have to go by. They've all got a job to do. I think we've all got a job to do.
Yes.
God pays a priest.
They all had a job to do, and his was the eighth in line. And so all the other priests are doing their thing, but he's got to do his thing. We've got to do the same thing.
Yes.
Whatever God has given us to do, no matter what it is, we've got to do it the way God said do it. And we're the only one that can do it, because God's given it to us to do. So look what it says here. And his wife was the daughter of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all 613 of the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blameless. Think about that.
Yeah.
They were both righteous.
Yeah.
They were both doing what God sent them to do.
Yes.
Completely. They kept all 613 of the laws and the commandments, and they walked pleasing to God.
Yes.
If my wife is not pleasing to God, then I can't do what I need to do here.
Yeah. That's right.
We've all got a purpose and a place in God's kingdom, and we've got to do it exactly like it needs to be done.
Amen.
We can't half do something.
Right.
Oh, look at this. And they had no child because Elizabeth was barren. Mm-hmm. And they were both well stricken in years. I want you to think about this a minute. Could me and Theta have a baby? I'm 78 years old. Could me and her have a baby and take care of it like a young person would take care of it? There'd be all kinds of hair being pulled out.
At least your hair get pulled out, I guarantee that.
Yeah. And it came to pass that while he executed the priest's office before God, in the order of his course, we've got to do it God's way.
Amen.
We can't do it our way. We've got to do it God's way.
Yeah.
If you've been here this morning, you've heard Wilkie say the same thing.
Yeah.
According to the customs of the priest's office, his lot was to burn incense when he went into the temple of the Lord. I want you to give me attention for just a minute. Right today, there is a mount where the temple of God is going to be rebuilt. There's 15 steps that he has to go up to get up to the temple. To open that door, inside that door there's a menorah, they call it. It's a light that he has to light when he goes in there. On the right side is a table of showbread, where the bread is there for the priest. There's a little altar about this size when you first go in the door, and you're looking straight ahead at the bell to where the Ark of the Covenant was supposed to be when it appears, and it's not appeared yet. So he's got to get his bow that he's got, and he's got to bring the incense, and he's got to buy the incense himself. They're not going to furnish nothing for him. He's got to have the incense, and he's got to have the coals from outside to put on that to get the perfume to come up and to fill the place. So he's doing what he's supposed to do exactly. When Elizabeth is considered as barren and can't bear a child, in those days, they was looked down on shamefully. That she can't do this, that's awful. Yet, she's living under all the commandments of God and doing them exactly like she's supposed to do them. And so, when they get ready to come into the house of God, verse 11 says, "And there appeared unto him an angel of the Lord standing on the right side of the altar of incense." If I'm him, I'm going to be just like this. An angel of God. Not just any angel. This is Gabriel. Stands in the presence of God, appears. Now you think about this a minute. What would you do? I know what I'd do. I'd quiver all over and I'd fall flat down. I'd be afraid to move. Because this is the almighty power of Almighty God that's sending him here to let you know something's about to take place.
Yes.
Something great is about to happen. "And there appeared unto him an angel of the Lord standing on the right side of the altar of incense. And Zacharias saw him, he was troubled, and fear fell upon him. But the angel of the Lord said unto him, Fear not, Zacharias, for thy prayer is heard."
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's big.
Yes, sir.
Thy prayer is heard. Mm-hmm. Don't you want your prayers to get through to God?
Amen.
You don't want to just bow down and say a bunch of stuff and get up and everything's okay. You want to make sure when you got saved, you had to make sure you was reaching the throne of God, didn't you? You had to get yourself away from yourself, and you had to get down and you had to ask God to forgive you of your sins in order for you to get saved. We need to pray that same way every time we get down. Because it's important that God hears your prayer. Man, I tell you what, I don't go through this life and go through all the aggravation this life gives and then end up going to the pits of hell because I didn't pray the way I was supposed to, live the way I was supposed to, do what I was supposed to do. It'd be awful. It'd be awful. So thank God his prayer is heard. Well, now why Zachariah so special? What makes him? Because he served God with all his heart, soul, mind, and strength.
Yes.
Elizabeth served God with all her heart, soul, mind, and strength to walk into that temple. I'm telling you, they got all the instruments right now ready to rebuild the temple. And it won't take 7 years like it did in the old days.
Yeah.
It'll be done quickly. Can you imagine? I think about this a lot. Just to walk on them steps, and 15 steps that leads up to the Temple Mount, just to walk on that place. We didn't get to do that when we was in Israel. We got to sit on the outside of the wall where Jesus had walked, but we didn't get to go on the inside where the Temple Mount is. To walk up them steps, walk over to that temple, and buddy, you better be right when you walk over that temple. I'm going to tell you. To walk over to that temple and reach and get a hold of them big double doors and step in there where the almighty presence of God is there. And yet, we can feel the almighty presence of God right here, right now. When we get ourselves out of the way and worship God in spirit and in truth and in power like we need to do, we can feel that same anointing power right here.
Yes.
It's real quiet in here today, isn't it? Real quiet. Oh, what would you do if Gabriel just appeared right here right now? Just like that. Oh, you hear a lot. Oh, God, forgive me of my simple ways. Oh, God, forgive me of my slothful ways. Oh, God, have mercy. Mm-hmm. We don't know when we're going to leave this world.
Right.
We better be ready now.
Amen.
And I mean, we better really be ready.
Really.
We better have our prayers caught up. So when you look at this piece of scripture, thou shalt have joy and gladness, and many shall rejoice at his birth. Whose birth? For he shall be great in the sight of the Lord, and shall drink neither wine nor strong drink, and he shall be filled with the Holy Ghost, even from his mother's womb.
Yes.
Look at verse 41. And it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutations of Mary, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
It happens. It happens because God's set it up that way. 400 years, they hadn't heard any prophet. They hadn't heard of any coming of God. He hadn't heard of anything for 400 years. And now here's Zacharias is coming to the temple, and the day is going to change for the rest of eternity what's about to happen on this hill today.
Yes.
Thank God. And he shall go before him in the spirit and the power of Elisha to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the disobedient to the wisdom of the just, to make ready a people prepared for the Lord. And Zacharias said unto the angel, whereby shall I know this? For I'm an old man. Excuses. For I'm an old man, and my wife is well stricken in years. We make excuses why we don't do things. We make excuses why we don't take care of things. Excuses won't cover your sins.
That's true.
When God tells us to do something, we need to do it. Mm-hmm. Is this okay this morning?
Yeah.
I just feel like teaching that we need to understand this.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
And Zacharias said unto the angel, verse 18, can you just imagine? You just come into the temple. You've put the oil in the lamp. You've got the light going, because the light's never supposed to go out, ever. And you brought the coals in, and you put your little bit of scent that you've worked out and got so that you could be a high priest and come into that temple. And the perfume is going out in that whole temple. And this angel of God appears in your presence. I built me an altar years ago. The Bible says you can't use a tool to build it. It's got to be built with 12 stones put together. So I was up there, and I thought I was praying, but the Spirit of the Lord came by, and I felt his presence this close to me, and I couldn't move. I was afraid to move. When that presence comes on you, and you can't even open your mouth, and you dare to open your mouth, and that presence is standing right here, and you know it's there. What are you going to do? All I can do is cry, because I was honored that it would come that close to stand by me. We need that with us every day that we live and everywhere we go and everywhere we walk. We need that presence of God right with us, and we need to know that it is there. We don't need to take a chance on this life. It's full of aggravation and heartaches, and we need Jesus more than anything on this entire planet, more than our life, more than just breathing. We need Jesus to be right here. We need to know that he's there. We don't want to take a chance on this, people. This is salvation. This is important.
Sir.
So think about this. And Zechariah said unto the angel, just talking to the angel, that's a big deal. Whereby shall I know this? For I'm an old man, and my wife is well stricken years. And the angel answered and said unto him, I am Gabriel. Can you hear that speaking in your ears? I'm Gabriel. That stands in the presence of God, and am sent to speak unto thee and to show thee things, these glad tidings. And behold, thou shalt be dumb and not able to speak until the day that these things shall be performed, because thou believest not my words, which shall be fulfilled in their season. John the Baptist is going to be born in Elizabeth's womb. He's been told this by an angel of God. I mean, standing right there telling him these things are going to happen.
Yes.
And yet, a little bit of unbelief sprinkles in. What's he going to say? Are you sure? Are you really talking to me? No, he's talking to him all right. He better listen. And the people waited for Zacharias and marveled that he tarried so long in the temple. And when he came out, he could not speak unto them. And they perceived that he had seen a vision in the temple, for he beckoned unto them and remained speechless.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Speechless. Mm-hmm. No sound come out of his mouth for 9 months. What can happen when we don't believe? When we question God?
Yeah.
How would you like to go through 9 months and you couldn't say a word? You couldn't make any sound at all. In my mind, I can see him open them doors and step back outside the temple wall. And all the people down here is praying for him while he's in there. But when he comes out and they know something's happening.
Yeah.
I just wonder, does God have to knock us down and stomp on us to make us realize that he's God and that he has all power? Everything that we will ever need as long as we're alive has to come from God.
Yes.
And we need him close.
Yes.
So if he comes to Ben Theta tonight and says, you're going to have another son, and he's going to baptize people, we better say, okay, Lord,
yeah.
Here am I.
Yes.
Like it or not.
Yes.
Like it or not. So I'm so glad that God sent him, because for 400 years there was nothing.
Yeah.
No religious things at all. They're going through the motions. They're going to the temple. They're doing their thing, but nothing's happening.
Mm-hmm.
Now, 3 BC, something happens. God says, Elizabeth's going to have a child. and his name is going to be John. They said, no, it'd be Zacharias Jr. No, his name is going to be John.
Yeah.
And you're waiting to see this man. He's not going to be the fine-dressed person you think he is. He's going to have camel's hair, eat wild locusts and honey, and he's going to be out there in the middle of the river preaching, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand, and that had never happened. That had never happened. Go back to the Old Testament, it never happened. But now, here stands John the Baptist, about 30-year-old, standing in the river, and people are coming to him.
Yeah.
And for the remission of sins, I baptize you. Only today's different. Somebody's walking up the shores of Galilee. Somebody's coming to the River Jordan. And there's something special about the one that's coming. There's a spirit about him that's unmistakable, that he's from God Almighty. And Jesus walks up to that River Jordan and he says, John, I need to be baptized of you because I'm starting a brand new ministry. And John said, but my Lord, I'm not even worthy to bow down and unloose your shoes. But he said, let it be done to fulfill all righteousness.
Yeah.
John takes Jesus in his arms, and he lowers him down in that water. And when he brings him up, Spirit of God comes from heaven all down on him like a spirit of Almighty God's power. Rests on him. Now, Jesus is set aside from the rest of the world. And what he's going to do now is change the world from that day to this day, that the glory of God can change your life and give you eternal life that you couldn't get it by yourself. He's going to give you eternal life because of what he's about to do. Yeah, he's going to heal a few people. Yeah, he's going to raise the dead. Yeah, he's going to cause a cripple to walk. But he's going to do something else.
Yeah.
He's going to walk up Calvary's mountain with a cross on his back. And he's going to give every drop of blood he's got so that you and I can have that blood applied to our soul that we can live forever.
Yeah.
The devil, Revelation 20, is going to get put in the pits of hell for eternity.
Yeah.
But you and I, I've got a supper to go to.
Yes.
The marriage supper of the Lamb.
Yes.
And that's the one I'm looking forward to.
Yes.
Everybody stand with me. Father, thank you, dear God, for the message of God's word. Thank you, Lord, that you love us so much that you would give us eternal life. Lord, have mercy upon us. Have mercy that we can be the vessel chosen to do whatever you need us to do and do it perfect. God, we need you. We need you to walk with us. We need you to talk to us. We need you to strengthen us in our life that we're living. And I ask you, dear God, in Jesus' name, send that spirit in this church. And Lord, if there's anyone lost and does not know Jesus and the free pardon of sin, let them be saved today. Lord, we praise you, we glorify you, we honor you. In the glorious name of Jesus, we pray. And amen and amen.
Jesus.
This altar is open. Somebody give us a song. Come on, folks, let's pray. Let's talk to God. We are so honored that God will let us even be here. That we can even stand up. You know, think about it. Strength that God has given to our life is amazing. And we're so blessed. So blessed that he would care about us. Enough that he would send his son, his only begotten son, to the cross to die for our sins. And without that blood, without that precious blood, you can't go to heaven. You must have the blood applied to your soul. That's the only way to go. What about you today? Are you ready to meet Jesus? Wide open. His presence takes charge of your life. exactly what he does. If you met Wilkie a few years ago, you'd think he was worth feeling in the world. Look at him now. God can change your life. God can give you eternal peace. Joy unspeakable, full of glory. Come to him seeking him while he is gone. Oh, what a joyous spirit is in this place.
God, saving
grace of Jesus Christ. Touch us, Lord. Let your spirit come in this place. Freedom that comes from the saving grace of God.
And
it's so wonderful. God, that he come to this realization, and he said, Psalms 51, have mercy on me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions,
yes.
Wash me thoroughly from my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sins. For I acknowledge my transgression and my sins is ever before me. You have to acknowledge those sins. You have to realize that you're a sinner, and you have to come to the only one that can save your soul, and that's Jesus Christ. He paid the full price so that you could live eternally. I'm so excited when this life is over, to walk up to them big pearly gates and have it open all by itself, and to hear a voice from the throne room saying, enter in,
Jesus,
thy good and faithful servant.
Yes. Yes.
There'll never be a better word than those right there. Come on, Will.
Praise the Lord. That was a great message.
Yes. Amen.
I always want to be hearing from the Lord. And I don't want to be like, which that was, that's the thing about it. Now, Lord ain't going to make let you stop if you want to mess something up.
Wow.
He won't intervene. He'll let us mess stuff up, but he's given us a better plan than Zechariah had. You know that?
Yeah.
Just think of that. I'm telling you. So thankful. Anybody got a word before we dismiss?
Thank God.
Yes, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank God.
Yes. Praise your Lord.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. What a day.
Woo.
Yes. What a day.
Praise you, Jesus.
He comes right in here when you do that.
Mercy walked in.
Yes.
Covered my sins.
Yes.
Oh, I thank you for covering my sins.
Yes.
For the blessed salvation. I praise him, honor and glory.
Yes,
Jesus.
The word shall
thank you, Master.
If you have got to testify, I've sat on it for the whole service. I started testifying, I'm like, I don't want to interrupt. I should have interrupted. You know, I see on Facebook, one has Facebook, and Josh Madison, one of his friends. We prayed a long time for a grandbaby. They prayed a long time for a baby. The doctor said no. He's going to say no, it's not going to be possible. That's what the doctor said.
Mm-hmm.
God said it's possible.
Right.
Yes. Yes.
I'm a good grandma.
Yay,
you
Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm so thankful. So thankful. They're just going to be on stage. We're praising God for it. They're giving him the glory. That's what we all have to do.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
Can we rejoice with her? Is it okay to rejoice with her?
Yes.
We don't ever need to get away from rejoice with her. Celebrate. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Master. Right? I scare the devil to death. I mean, you know, we don't need to be backwards about nothing. Somebody get saved. Praise you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Honor you, Lord. Worship you, Lord. We've been taught to be so quiet. Praise you, Lord. I tell you, he gets involved. That's so good. Good news. Robert, got to tell us about it again. You talking
about
shrinking.
Shrinking. Yeah.
Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You're the healer.
Well, you know, when Kim had the twins,
mm-hmm.
the doctors told us, said, you don't remember, we're about taking no birth control. You'll never have no more kids because you know, she had to do all that kind of stuff to get to have the twins.
There's Macy.
There's Macy.
Macy said, oh no, he's going to do it again. Praise you, Lord. Uncle Wilkie's going nuts, ain't he? That's all right. That's all right.
I thank the Lord for answering prayers, too, because, I mean, many of you know that we went through a lot with James. He's not here today because he's still
honeymooning.
You know, we went through a lot of stuff, and it just seemed so dark. And,
yes.
It seemed so dark, and we just felt hopeless a little bit at times. And, but God brought him back, and, you know, sometimes the Lord has to make them see.
Yeah.
You know, he has to make them see what life is like without him.
Yeah.
And it's for people are stubborn. It's a hard road, but I thank the Lord. You know, James told me the other day, he said, Mom, this is my first Christmas being fully sold out saved. You know, it's said that way, but I mean, he was just like so excited to him. It's his first Christmas, and he can really celebrate, you know, the way you want to, the way we can as Christians, you know. And that's that's something to me.
Christmas is real.
Yeah.
I thank God for that.
Yeah, I mean, it gets real.
Praise you, Lord.
There, praise you, Lord. Hey, we ought to be the praises people ever want. We ought to. What are you doing for us? Mercy.
Yes. When James was having those bad headaches, and he still has them sometimes, but not like he was, little James come over to the house, him and Alicia, and he said, Papa, can I pray for you?
Yeah, it's good. Mm-hmm.
James said, you can. Mm-hmm. And he said, I'm going to pour this oil. He poured the oil on his papa's head, and he prayed over his papa.
Yeah.
Forgot to touch him. And I said, life is just in awe. I was standing there thinking, Lord, thank you, Jesus, what you have done for this boy.
Yeah. He's down in the walls in praying for people.
Good.
Yeah.
His aunt gave him some oil. An oil. We went to that revival up there, and she came back and gave him one night, gave him the oil. And thank you, Aunt Carol.
That's why he poured over the papa.
Yeah. Put two little mustard seeds in the oil.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, so that's you and Lee. I mean, that's such a sweet, thoughtful gift. And but he used it. He got that. He didn't have a. I said, you can't put it.
Never mind.
But anyway, he was praying for a guy who couldn't find a prayer cloth. He got toilet paper for somebody. I said, now, you got to get some because that oil ate that up, buddy. You can't do it like that. But his heart's there.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know what I'm
saying?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Love it.
Yes.
Yeah, be praying for him, and I want him to continue to do good.
Yes, sir.
All right. We've got a lot to thank God for, don't we?
Yes, we do.
Well, all of Zayden's blood work came back good.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And he had his x-ray last week, so just pray that it comes back.
Yeah.
It will.
Yeah.
Amen.
And let's not forget Shirley on Wednesday when she has that biopsy. She, right. I think they're doing it to rule out because, you know, they always have to check further when they see something. But I'm confident it's going to be okay.
Right.
Mine too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Good reports.
Mommy went to the doctor this past week. She was real pleased with you, Mommy. She said her legs look better.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise your Lord. Lord.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes. Mommy, she's probably going to be sending me somewhere else. We didn't go nowhere else.
Praise
right.
the Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's having a mammogram soon, but her legs look really good, so I'm thankful for that.
Yes, amen.
So
I'll be praying for her brother, too. He's in the hospital with pneumonia.
That's good for Jesus.
Oh, sure.
That's Jesus.
I'm praying for Rodney. He's went to church now. Two Sundays in a row. Okay.
Awesome.
That's
awesome.
I hope that's where he's at today.
Yeah. Praise your Lord.
For lost in our family. You know, there has to be a stop to these.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, the law knows it. I mean, they've been up there. A woman on the hill died day before yesterday, and they robbed a poor old woman's house or her building that night.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, it's so sad, but the aggravation, and I've been there before with this. You know, years ago, I mean, it was bad. But something happened, I would get so mad that I'd just go run and pray. Well, here lately, I ain't been doing that. But God answered my prayer years ago in a way I'd never even seen coming.
Mm-hmm. See where?
And Kenneth Collins was a bus driver. I couldn't keep him out of my driveway, hardly. I couldn't get out of my driveway. Because they was parked in the road on it. Ken Collins come through there, and he hit something in my yard, and he thought he'd get him in lots. Well, he called the school and told me he did. Well, then he called me to apologize. I said, you didn't hit my mailbox. He said, well, I hit something. I said, you hit some lock that we've got around our water meter, so they wouldn't get us hit.
Yeah.
And he had hit that. He said, well, it's too late, I done reported it. Well, honey, here comes the state police putting them out of that road.
Preachable.
Yeah.
And said that was in prayers.
Yeah.
Right.
Let me get back there.
Yeah. Because
this is getting bad. I mean, you can't see old things. You know, we got cameras up. But, you know, once your stuff's gone, it's gone. You won't have the time to get it back.
Yeah, I heard a story, a testimony, of a woman who had a lot of drug dealing. The Lord told her to take a bottle of oil and go right down there, right there. He said, the drug dealer's gone, I mean, that night. I mean, it's not that oil did anything. It's just her faith and whatever it was.
Yeah.
And God will do stuff like that.
Yeah.
Let's help release them, because that's a bad place to be. When you're surrounded by evil, when you want to do good, you're surrounded by evil and hearing evil all the time.
Because all you do is stay angry.
You can change it, though. I mean,
I thought about going out and turning my car, my Christian music on wide open. You know, just see how they, I'm really, you know,
yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
You know, I feel like hollering saying, hey, if every word you're saying is that, you know, have some respect for your neighbors if you don't think so.
Right.
You know, I ain't got virgin ears, I'm sorry, but I mean, this is ridiculous.
Yeah.
But the law ain't gonna do nothing. Just pray that I'll get back there and let God make your way.
Ask them to go to church week.
I'm so angry.
Ask them to go to church week.
I pray for them.
Go ask them to go to church week.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all, go to church week. Don't forget my cousin, husband had a stroke and they're both, they're lost. Please pray for their salvation.
Oh, yes.
All right. Well, we'll all stand and remember that, and remember Shirley. What's the Shirley?
That's what I was saying. You know, just talk about them drug dealers. You know, back summer, I scared them to live where I live. I was fixing to move out. Yeah. The Lord moved all them people out. They're by that neighborhood so good to me now. They bring me things, and all I done was pray and ask them to come to church.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ask them God to church.
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right.
Pray
for my brother. Yes. Yeah. Pray. I've got something I'm going to take care of tomorrow. Lord knows.
Heard you got something, buddy?
No. Brother Charles, if you would dismiss us still.
Lord, our Father, we bow our heads this morning, Father, in the precious name of Jesus. Father, I'm thanking you, Lord, for what I have felt during this morning.
Yes, Lord.
You have filled me with your love.
Yes.
I appreciate all that, dear Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Now go with us, lead us, guide us, and